things have gone a little bumpy for scooter startups in San Francisco lately. Despite the wide use of Lime, Bird, and Spin scooters throughout the city, criticism has been mounting for its unregulated use and the irresponsible ways these scooters are left behind after use, littering the streets of San Francisco. CA Bill 2989 is looking to keep these scooters on the city sidewalks, allowing users to go up to 20 miles per hour while only requiring minors to wear helmets. But just last week, an opposing resolution was filed. It looks like the scooter saga is going to continue in San Francisco, with users that we talked to today seeing both sides of the debate. Co-workers Heidi and Jen are scooter first-timers who were quickly won over with the ease and efficiency of the transportation alternative. But the two admit there are things to work on.
Sometimes I think people take them into your own buildings, and then it just kind of disappears, so that part
was a little
frustrating.
We had a little bit of tough time searching for one. So.
Oh, really?
Yeah. It was like, it looked like it was there, but it looked like it might have been like hidden away or in a building, so that was a little tough, but we found one, and hopefully these will last us to where we need to go.
The same observations go for avid user Olivia, who says scooter use on narrow city streets can become quite a nuisance.
Here on Embarcadero, along the water, this sidewalk is wider. So it's not so bad, but I can understand for somebody who's like, you know, more inter downtown where the street, where the sidewalks are more narrow, then yeah, I can understand where people get like irritated.
And for this tourist from Oklahoma, despite various scooter services problems, he can't wait for a similar service to roll out in his part of the country.
I would absolutely love to see them out there.
And you would use it every day?
Yeah, I would. It's affordable too.
It's no wonder why these scooters have seemingly taken over San Francisco. These scooters get you where you need to go without the hassles of other transportation options. Signing up is easy. Start by downloading any of the scooter apps and creating an account. Bird asks to scan a driver's license if it's your first time and also requires users to agree to rental rules. Then scan, unlock a scooter, and you're ready to scoot. Most of the services cost $1 per half-hour ride, with incremental charges depending on excess miles or minutes thereafter. Some also offer monthly subscription rates. While there may be roadblocks ahead for scooter companies, as of now, they are very much still on track to becoming the most popular alternative in the city commute. And that's it this week on Tech Discovery. I'm Ginger Conejero.